Hello students, today's video is regarding a very important statement which is usually asked in the subject called auditing. A few moments later, I have received a few messages regarding a very important statement, an auditor is a watchdog, not a bloodhound, that I should explain this statement in the form of a written way. I have made a video on it, on this statement as well, but lots of comments has been coming in front of me that I have to make a video on this statement in a form of notes or in the form of written way. So in this video I will explain this statement, that means an auditor is a watchdog, not a bloodhound, in a form of a written way. So as this questions comprises of very high marks, so this, for this question the perfect answer has been explained by me in this video. So let's start this answer. First, it was a kind of decision of a particular case in which the justice or the judge says this statement. Means this statement was said by a kind of case. I will talk about that case also, but this statement is particularly said by the judge. The meaning of this statement is auditor should work by considering that everything is normal and he should not always look after at the mistakes or fraud is being done, then only I am appointed here. The meaning of this is this paragraph is saying that auditor should work by considering. Means if an auditor is appointed, he should not feel like that mistakes has been happened in the company, that only due to that I am appointed here. Either thinking this type of things, he should say or he should think and do the work that there is no mistake, no fraud has been there, and I have appointed here to for an auditing of a company as is a procedure, as is a regular task performed by a company. So he should not be think in such a way. Next, that's why we say that an investigator act as a bloodhound but an auditor is a watchdog. Yes, if after, listen, one thing is need to be taken care of, that after auditing, investigation is been done by a proprietor. If he is not satisfied by an auditor's work, then investigator will be appointed by the proprietor and he will work as a bloodhound, which is means that in that the proprietor has think that auditor has not done his work perfectly, then only I am appointed here. Then investigator will be work as bloodhound, but an auditor should work like a watchdog. In 1896, there was a case, Justice Slopes and Kingston Cotton Mills. This case explains this statement in very perfect way. Now, what's this case is? In the mill, there was a stock verification. So while auditing, the auditor who has appointed there has not done the verifications of stock personally. Means he's not gone and checked the either the stock has been maintained very in a perfect way or not. Instead of this, he has taken the report from the members of the company related that stock. Means he had not checked the stock, but he had taken the report that the stock is perfect from the members of the company. And according to that report, only he prepared his audit report for the company. Therefore, when shareholder got to know that auditor has done such kind of things, that he has not checked the stocks physically and taken the report by verbally, then they started doing objections and gone to the court and also filed a writ against that auditor. After discussion was made in the court, then the Justice Slopes had said that an auditor has taken the certificate that stocks are verified. So here auditor is not liable for any mistake happened, because an auditor is a watchdog, not a bloodhound. He only asks you that whether it is correct or not. He will check the rest of the things also, but if he asks you the stock, if he wants, then he can check also. It's upon him. But he can also do auditing by asking that whether it is perfect or not. And if you are saying that it is a perfect, then he will ask for a certificate or a kind of a letter that you are taking the guarantee that this stock has been correct. Then I am not responsible if this stock is going to be wrong, because he is a watchdog, not a bloodhound, said by the Justice Slopes. The work which he was supposed to do has done by him verification of stock can be done him physically or orally. Means he can do verification of the stock, either he can take the report or either he can simply take the report orally and ask the members of the company that it is correct or not, or he can also do the checking of the stock physically. It's upon him that which of the either or option is going to be opted by him. So an auditor not work like a bloodhound. He should not work by making up his mind that the company has done a mistake, then only I am appointed here. He should not work like that. Either he has to work there by taking up in the mind that a company is a regular, it's a kind of a regular procedure which needs to be done, and company has done a mistake, then only I'm appointed here, should not be think by an auditor, because he is not an investigator, said by the Justice Lopes. Under this statement, if it is asked in examination, then we have to consider some duties which is regarding, which should be mentioned in these kind of question. That duties of auditor on the basis of above statement. This statement comprising the answer from here, from it is a kind of decisions from here to here. But this Justice Lopes, but duties of the auditor on the basis of our statement should be mentioned in this answer. It is very important to mention these things also. In this, first is he should be very honest. He should not be an auditor should be very honest. An auditor should not be suspicious. An auditor should not work in a pressure. An auditor should follow the principles in belief. An auditor should follow the principles of belief. He should be alert to his work. He should obey the and confidence about his work, about the employer, office employer. He should be very confident and obey all the rules and regulations made by the council, made by the authority. He should not be the nature of bloodhound. He is a watchdog, not a dog of a street. He must be think that he is a kind of a watchdog. He is not a dog of a street. If there is a wrong document presented in front of him, then only he has authority to bark. He should not bark on every kind of document presented on him. So make clear about it. He is not a spy. Means detective. He should not be in a nature of the people who is working in detective agency. He always work like and he should not work like a spy. Spy मतलब होता है जासूस. Detective agency के लोगों का nature है कि वो बात नहीं करते, हमेशा silent रहते हैं. और हम जो बात करेंगे वे उसे पकड़ेंगे. सो ऑडिटर शुड नॉट बी डू सच काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. ही शुड नॉट सी ओनली अरिथमेटिक एरर्स. अरिथमेटिक एरर्स तो देखना ही है, एज वेल एज ही शुड सी द फ्रॉड्स ऑल्सो. ही शुड टेल इन द रिपोर्ट. एन ऑडिटर कैन नॉट गिव गारंटी ऑफ ट्रूथनेस. यस, एन ऑडिटर कांट से दैट अकाउंट विच यू हैव प्रेजेंटेड इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी इज 100% ट्रू, बिकॉज 100% एक्यूरेसी. On 100% accuracy, he should be provided a certificate, but he is not providing a certificate, he is providing an auditor's report. So it should not be 100% accurate, because the auditor report is not 100% accurate. At last, not helpful in checking of black money. No, an auditor is not helpful in checking of black money, because sometimes an auditor can also involve himself in malpractices. So auditor only checks the report which is prepared by the company. So this is the full answer for this statement. I have got lots of emails and lots of messages regarding this question that I have to explain in the form of a written way. So I have made this video. Hope you like this video. Do share and subscribe my channel Manish Kumar for my important topics to get all important lectures regarding BCom. Thank you.